Well, the first film, Aliens, was such a big, Alien in the singular, was such a big success back in 1979, they decided to make a sequel, and it's called Aliens, plural, with an S. One of the stars, now, everybody in Nebraska, you gotta get the picture. This is Michael Biehn. He plays the role of Hicks. He's from Lincoln. He's from Lincoln, Nebraska, and I wasn't quite sure who he was. Now, come on, identify yourself, Michael. Who are you? Who are you? Come on now. What is this? Where have you been all my life, huh?
Yeah, I'm from Lincoln. I grew up there. I went to grade school and junior high.
Tell us where.
I went to Calvert school. I would have gone to Southeast High School. I went to Pound Junior High School. That's right. And left there when I was 14 and went to and lived in Arizona. So I didn't. My older brother went to Southeast, and we all played a little league in the area, and my dad was an attorney. And
what was your dad's name?
Biehn, Don Biehn.
Don Biehn. What kind of an attorney was he?
He does, divorces and that sort of stuff.
So he left. You left with him when you all went out to Arizona. Were you involved in any theatrical productions?
I did theater when I was in Nebraska. I did a community theater. I did a production of Rags to Riches, and I can remember doing a production of Pinocchio and a production of Alice in Wonderland. All it was community theater.
Community Playhouse?
That's right.
Did you know at that time, did you say, I'm going to be an actor when I grow up?
No, I had fun doing it, but I was involved in sports a lot, and I was in high school, actually. I was doing some theater in high school, and I got a scholarship to college because a dean in the drama department at the University of Arizona saw me. This was when I was after I left Lincoln. I was living in Arizona, and I went on to college and took the scholarship thinking, well, I might teach or something like that and maybe coach. And I didn't really like the theater program because it was stagecraft classes and all this stuff, not acting. So I went out to Los Angeles, and that's really when I decided I was going to give it a try. And I had no idea it was going to, you know.
Isn't this odd? The first thing you did was Terminator, right?
No. Well, I've been in a lot of things. Actually, the first big film that I did was a movie called The Fan, about 5 years ago with Lauren Bacall.
Mm, oh, that's right.
Which really was a disaster in a lot of different ways. It was like the most uncreative set I've ever been on, and there were a lot of problems with it. It was a story about a fan who idolizes this movie star and tries to kill her. And Lennon was shot about 6 months before that movie opened, and Reagan was shot, and the Pope was shot, and the movie opened, and nobody went to see it. It wasn't that good of a movie anyway. And that didn't help my career very much. But I went on for a while, didn't work for a while after that. Then I did a movie called Lords of Discipline for Frank Rodham, which was about the first Martin Breland, who was a Golden Gloves fighter, or Olympic fighter, gold medal winner, was in that. And after that, I did The Terminator. That was after.
Well,
that.
Now you're playing a role with Sigourney Weaver.
That's right.
And it's called Aliens, of course. How do you like playing second fiddle to the special effects?
Well, I don't think that we do play second fiddle to special effects. Unless, you know, if you think, you know, if you look at a movie like Alien, and if you, in the same way with Alien as with Aliens, I think that the characters are strong and that they have a lot of integrity. And the actors in this, Bill Paxton and Lance Henriksen, and Paul Reiser are all very, very good actors, and of course Sigourney Weaver. Mm-hmm. So I think that our story is extremely strong, and it's not a special effects movie, it's a story about people.
How long has it been since you got any sleep? 24 hours?
Hicks, I'm not gonna end up like those others. You'll take care of it, won't you?
If it comes to that, I'll do us both. Listen, let's just make sure it doesn't come to that.
Was it hard to do physically? Was it a hard film
very
to
difficult.
Do?
Very difficult physically. The Terminator, I thought, was a difficult movie to do physically. But in this one, we, as Marines, wore this armor. And it was very heavy, and we were carrying around these very, very heavy rifles and running through, like, all these air conditioning vents and stuff. And it, you can do it once, you can do it twice, but take after take after take after take.
And the guns looked heavy, too. Everything
they are
heavy.
They had two guns in the set. They had, like, the real heavy ones that are good because they make your muscles stick out. And
let me check. Let's see. After Schwarzenegger, though,
I was just kidding. But then they have real light ones that you can use. Because the other ones are so heavy. But as an actor, you don't want to be thinking about, like, trying to make the rifles heavy, because you'll be running and all of a sudden you'll be going like this with this, you know, 60-pound rifle. It looks stupid,
yeah,
so
yeah.
Try to use the heavy ones. But, yeah, it was a pretty tough shoot.
You know, the curious thing about this, he comes to be one of the good guys. One of the good guys with the two strong women. This is really, I think, a woman's film in the sense that the women are the warriors, the women are the women and you are the stronger.
You know, Jim Cameron has made a couple movies now because in The Terminator, the Sarah Connor role is a very strong role for a woman. And again, in this movie, it's Ripley is a very strong woman, and she actually ends up battling another pretty strong woman. And I think it's great. I think it's nice to see films where, you know, we have for so many years, you have the men that are always dragging the women behind them. So it's nice to see a change.
Mm-hmm. How did you meet up with the director, James Cameron?
I met him when The Terminator went in, just like most jobs at the cast in Hollywood. They send you a script, you take a look at it. If you like it, you go in and read for it, which I did, and went and read for it, and he liked me and cast me for it. And then just called me up for this one and said, do you want to be in it?
So you didn't have to audition or anything?
Not for Alien.
What's next, Michael?
I don't know. We'll see.
We'll see how well this does.
I know how well this will do.
Come back and see us in Nebraska.
Okay.
Will you do that, Michael?
Let's see if we get those Cornhuskers going, all right?
Listen, Cornhuskers are going. Just as you say, this is going to be a successful film. The Cornhuskers are number one, right?
I hope so.
Right. You got
no sweat.
No sweat. Michael Biehn from Nebraska. How about that? He's one of the star of the Aliens. Please stay with us. We'll be right back right after this word.